The arts of the Etheria.
In late 2014, I spoke a couple of times in person with 17th degree Freemason Keith King. He is an author and also produces films, and one of his films is called Will the Real Harry Potter Stand Up? And it was through talking with him or either in that film that there was mention of the character Charlie within Harry Potter, that Charlie is a kind of representation of Prince Charles, and that Charlie goes off and studies dragons. So that caught my attention, because dragons would be elemental creatures. And so we'll just read though about Charlie for a second. So Charlie Weasley was the second eldest son of Arthur and Molly Weasley. So Charlie attended the Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry from 1984 to 1991, and was sorted into the Gryffindor house. Now within there you get Griffin within that word there. So another alchemical elemental creature. He was both a prefect and Quidditch captain during his time at school, and after graduating he went to study dragons in Romania. So it's really interesting that he goes and studies dragons in Romania, and we'll get to that. So during the Second Wizardry War, Charlie was a member of the Second Order of the Phoenix and fought the Battle of Hogwarts in 1998, arriving with reinforcements during the final portion of the battle. After the war, Charlie continued his work with dragons. Now, just to go on here, in this part in the wiki there, canon relationships, this is about the Weasley family, and this is kind of interesting. Charlie had a good relationship with his family. So his parents, Arthur and Molly Weasley, were both pure blood wizards who loved their children very much and cared about them. However, they were economically poor and were considered by many as blood traitors, because they were not prejudiced against muggles and muggle-borns. So there are various things in there to do with bloodlines, blood traitors, and also this going to study dragons in Romania overall.
His Royal Highness Prince Charles, who can trace his ancestry back to Romania's dark and distant past.
The genealogy shows that I'm descended from Vlad the Impaler, you see. So I do have a bit of a stake in the country.
As it were.
So as we look through some various images from Romania, occult-related images, I'll just speak for a moment to what Prince Charles has said in some further aspects. So Prince Charles says that his genealogy traces back to Vlad the Impaler, and of course it would go further back from there. Vlad the Impaler, Vlad III, Prince of Wallachia. Now he was born in 1431 and lived to the age of about 44, 45. So he died in either 1476 or 1477. Now he was a member of the House of Draculesti, and his father was Vlad II Dracul, and he was a member of the Order of the Dragon. Vlad the Impaler, he was born in Transylvania. We have within the genealogy there, and Vlad II being a member of the Order of the Dragon. So this kind of links in, I would suggest, with, and we can show images from around Romania with the dragon imagery and all the rest of it, and within the castles. So it kind of links in with Prince Charles. Prince Charles, the dragon. Yes, the dragon, the symbology can be seen. I would suggest there's more to it than just the symbology. So within the ritual scenario, the dragon is actually an elemental creature, an elementally formed creature within various magic ritual situations. Hence, there comes that whole magic aspect that was talked about through Harry Potter that leads into this. But nonetheless, that's kind of very remote from many of the lives that people live in society, so they just don't see that part of it could possibly be real. Just further from here though, we'll just have a look at castles. So you have Palais Castle, and there is a well there, and you can see the lions there. So I would suggest they're emerging out from the foliage. And this, the lions emerging from the foliage, I can show other examples of that, including the example at the Town Hall of Sydney in Australia. Also, you have Bran Castle. Now, Bran Castle is in Transylvania, where Vlad the Impaler, through the genealogy of Prince Charles, you know, this is where that all comes through, where Vlad the Impaler was born. And within Bran Castle, you can see esoteric features, including, well, on the way there, you can see the cross with the four around the one configuration, I would suggest. And within there, you can see the crown with the etheric tree being represented there, going through it, through that crown chakra. Also there, you have yet another well with the interdimensional symbology around that, what is a representation, I would suggest, of a portal way. At Poinary Castle, you have the sticks there, the spikes relating to Vlad the Impaler. And just for a moment, another thing caught my eye, and this is from the Mufetla Cave Complex, which is in Romania. And you have the lion form with the human head there, and you can sort of see this form represented within Freemasonry also. This, I would suggest, is yet another astral elemental creature being represented here. So all up, I hope you found this video interesting. Just a little bit of a tie-in there with Harry Potter, with Charlie going to Romania, studying dragons, but mainly that magic aspect behind it all, the part that people would leave out of Charlie going to study dragons. And it is this aspect, I would suggest, that is a kind of great divide, if you will, between certain people in society and the main of society who are just not involved in the organized magic rituals. Just as a bit of an extra note, here you have this graphic with the witch in it from Romania. Now, in Sydney, in Annandale on Johnson Street, you have the witches' houses there, as they're commonly known, and you can see the architecture there. Now, going to Romania, you can see that architecture within the countryside, particularly in churches and monasteries, that Gothic architecture within Romania. So I just thought I would include this. Bye for now.